What's up, y'all? It's the Magi, and it's time for another one. So, we're going to do something a little different today, even though it pertains to the overall scope of what's been going on around in entertainment. But it's something that was brought to my attention by a fellow YouTuber out here. And I'm going to big shout to Liana K. I check her stuff out. She does a lot of stuff on gaming and, what's a good one she did? I love the Benevolent sexism, which is a real good topic, which is kind of what this is a little bit about, but not necessary. But big shout to her for bringing this topic to my attention. And what we're talking about is a cosplayer by the name of Yoshia Fluff. Sorry if I got that wrong. So she did a 2B cosplay, right? And that's why I have 2B in the thumbnail and 2B behind me. I like 2B. It's a dope character, especially if you play the game. You know what I'm talking about. But anyway, she looked fantastic as 2B, right? And what she did was she went and she had Yoko Taro, who's the creator. He works for Square Enix. I believe that's all together with the Final Fantasy team. He's one of the creative developers on the game. So he had her sign her thigh. You know, it's what it is, you know, whatever. But then here's what ends up happening. You get a bunch of people who are not her get up on Twitter and start spewing their point of view. So they basically are using their point of view on her expressions, basically. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're infringing on her expression to use her own mind. And I want to get into why this falls into something that I wanted to talk about in a minute. But let's just take a look at what this person said real quick. So, and I'm not putting a person's name up here because that's what they want. They like that kind of attention because clearly it's got to be for some kind of attention for you. So it basically puts, inside of the side of the top of someone's thigh, but it's kneeling. F no, yo. That's weird as hell. Don't do that ish. Respect your young fans. Okay. All right. And we continue with this. It says, it's a dude in their 40s or 50s signing the upper thigh of a young fan. I've got a lot more awareness on the context, but literally none of it is relevant at this juncture. He's responding to other things. But I just was curious that he said a guy in his 40s or 50s. Okay. But let's take a look at what we're dealing with here. Here's the act right here, where she's getting her thigh signed, right? Boom. Does this look like... You're making it sound like this is some underage girl. That's a woman. Okay? That's a woman. Let's be perfectly clear on this, right? Who cares if he's in his 40s, 50s, 60s, 80s? Who cares? If she's a consenting adult, who the F are you to say what's... You're basically putting your moralities and your thoughts onto her. She's expressing herself with the outfit that she has on, the 2B outfit, right? But then you're infringing on her ability to think for herself by saying, oh, you, essentially what you're saying is you can't think for yourself, I gotta do it for you. So, which brings me to the point that I wanted to get at in regards to myself and in the fan young woman went through in regards to this douchebag basically, infringing on her. It's the same concept you see all around fandoms, period, and especially in regards to, you know, the Twitterverse, where you get people up there who want to be offended for you or do this for you. When we talk about consenting adults, same thing as when you're talking about, I don't know, when it comes to black and brown people in media, or specifically, like, myself in regards to, like, being in the fandom menace. You never hear them talk about, you know, people like me who didn't like Star Wars. It's always, you always try to paint other people in a corner, but then you ignore me because why? You got to think for me? You should have your characters representation on screen because you say so? I don't need you to tell me what I need to be represented by. Same thing with this woman. You don't need you to tell her what she can and can't do with her body. And by the way, let's be perfectly clear. Ladies, here's a bit of toxic masculinity for you. If you ever want me to sign anything and you ask, I'm going to do it. You know why? Because you asked. if somebody asks me to do something, look, I've gone to concerts all the time, especially hip hop shows, whatever. And people have on a shirt, like, oh, can you sign my shirt while you're wearing it? People do that all the time. It's the same thing. So what? It was her thigh. She asked for him to do it. So the same thing I'm saying. I don't need anybody to speak for me in regards to what I like in entertainment, what I don't like in entertainment, what I need to see on screen, what I don't need to see on screen, okay? That's not up for you to decide. It's up for me to decide. What you think is perfectly fine for you. I'm not going to come and tell you, hey, you shouldn't think that. Sure, you can think that. I would recommend not putting it on Twitter so you look like an idiot. You can think you feel some kind of way about some guy signing a woman's leg, right? You would think that. You can. It's perfectly fine. Me personally, I wouldn't put my thoughts like that on Twitter. You know what I'm saying? Same thing in regards to the political spectrum. I'm not going to put my thoughts about politics on Twitter. You know why? You know, I might have a quick commentary on things, but if you want to hear me talk about anything, that's what my music's for, right? So, but short end of that is that, listen, it is not your place to tell me, to tell her, to tell him what they can and can't do with themselves or what they can and cannot like. That's not up to you. Now, you can have your own thoughts. You can do whatever you want. You can put them on Twitter. But then we're going to point and laugh at you and make fun of you when you make up stupid things like this. And again, the reason why I didn't put this person's name on there is not because of whatever, because I don't want to get that person the shine that they want. You see, that's what it ends up being. Because when you put up stupid things like this, it's more or less like you're trying to get some shine off of saying something stupid, because that was really dumb. It was real dumb. So, bottom line is, you can have your opinions and your thoughts. I can have my opinions and thoughts. I'm not going to impose my thoughts on you, and I sure as heck don't want you imposing yours on mine. That's how this works. That's how it all works. So, let me know how you feel about that in the comments. Do you think it is appropriate for anyone to tell somebody else what they can and can't like, what they can and can't do with their bodies, you know, whatever, you know? It drives me crazy. Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit that notification bell so you keep my face when I drop it. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace. Seek peace and justice and fish and level. My planet is spotless on top of